know what it is.
Oh, it is.
It's very similar.
Thank you.
Christmas to one and all. It is truly a blessing to be able to gather here tonight to celebrate the birth of the Christ child. You know, the world into which Jesus was born was not so unlike our world today. As is true in so many places in the world, the people of that time also experienced deep and painful losses, destructive conflicts, and so much fear, so much fear. Unjust power and violence threatened the lives of the innocent. In fact, as our beloved story was unfolding, a king was plotting to destroy this very child who was still unborn. And yet into that world of fear, God brought wonder and hope and peace and joy and love. Just when we are about to give up on everything, God surprises us with new life. Just when we think there is no more innocence to be found, an infant is placed in our arms and we feel once again that beauty and simplicity. Just how life is meant to be. So tonight is not a night for doctrine and dogma. It is not a time for me to pontificate about what this all means. But rather, this is a time for reflection. Reflection on the story of one particular birth and one particular child who would grow to be the one we call the Christ. It is a time to celebrate new life and wonder and joy. It is a time to call forth the hope that every birth brings to the deepest regions of our hearts. So tonight I invite you to listen again, open to hearing a new message for a new time in your life. May this story tonight pierce the ragged edges of our lives and remind us once again that God dwells with us, incarnate in an infant that we call Jesus.
To us in self-emptying love, The moment that we enter the mystery of this Christmas birth. Amen.
Psalm 96.
Oh, sing to the Lord a new song. Sing to the Lord, all the earth. Sing to the Lord, bless his name. Tell of his salvation from day to day. Declare his glory among the nations, his marvelous works amongst all the peoples. For great is the Lord, and greatly to be praised. He is to be revered above all gods. For all the gods of the peoples are idols. But the Lord made the heavens. Honor and majesty are before him. Strength and beauty are in his sanctuary. Ascribe to the Lord, O families of the peoples. Ascribe to the Lord glory and strength. Ascribe to the Lord the glory due his name. Bring an offering and come into his courts. Worship the Lord in holy splendor. Tremble before him, all the earth. Say among the nations, the Lord is King. The world is firmly established. It shall never be moved. He will judge the people with equity. Let the heavens be glad, and let the earth rejoice. Let the sea roar, and all that fills it. Let the field exult, and everything in it. Then shall all the trees of the forest sing for joy before the Lord, for he is coming. For he is coming to judge the earth. He will judge the world with righteousness and the peoples with his truth.
Would all who are able please stand and let us join our voices with the voices of creation. Lying in a manger.
reading. To listen, to look. By Anne Weems. Is it all sewn up in my life? Is it at this point so predictable, so orderly, so neat, so arranged, so right, that I don't have time or space for listening to the rustle of an angel's wings? Or running to a stable to see the baby? Could this be what he meant when he said, listen, those who have ears to hear, look, those who have eyes to see. Oh God, give me the humbleness of those shepherds who saw in the cold December darkness the coming of light, the advent of love.
Behold the star of Bethlehem, the Word of God has become flesh, and unto us a child is born, the Savior of this broken world. Oh, hear the angels' voice.
a multitude of heavenly hosts, praising God and saying, glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth, peace among those whom he favors.
An Aztec story of nativity from Imaging the Word, Volume 1. The angels came down from the sky like birds. Their voices were bells. They sounded like flutes. Praise God in heaven, hallelujah. They came flying out of the sky, singing, peace on earth, hallelujah. Now, the sweet-smelling sunflowers were scattering everywhere, falling to earth in a golden rain. Let's scatter these golden flowers, hallelujah. The flowers were heavy with dew, and the dew was filled with light, shining like jewels in Bethlehem. Hallelujah. Heart flowers, plume bell flowers, red cup flowers. Oh, they're beaming with dawn light. They're shining like gold. Hallelujah. Emeralds and pearls and red crystals were glowing. They're glistening. It's dawn. Hallelujah. Jewels are spilling into Bethlehem, falling to earth. Hallelujah.
They are new
every morning. The Lord gave the people of the earth a garden, and the people said, "Oh, that's very nice, God, but that's not enough. We'd like a little knowledge, please." The Lord God gave them knowledge, and the people said, "Well, now that we have knowledge, we would like things." So the Lord gave the people things, but they always said, "That's not quite enough." So the Lord God gave them gifts unequaled: the sun, lightning and thunder, rain and flowers, animals and birds and fish, trees and stars, and the moon. God gave them the rainbow. God parted the Red Sea and gave them manna. God gave them prophets and children and each other. But still the people said, that's not enough. God loved the people, and out of ultimate merciful goodness, God gave them the gift of gifts, a Christmas present never to be forgotten. God gave them love in the form of God's Son, even Christ Jesus. There are some that don't open their eyes or their ears or their hearts, and they still say, "Well, that's just not quite enough." They wander through the stores looking for Christmas. But others, they open their whole being to the Lord, bending their knees to praise God, carrying Christmas with them every day. For these, the whole world is a gift.
When I began my ministry, I was an intentional interim pastor, which means that I was only in a church between pastors, so a year and a half, 2 years at the most. What that meant was that sometimes the jobs just didn't line up, and I could be 1 month or 2 months, sometimes up to 4 months without income. And such was the time when, unbeknownst to me, my home pastor made a call to the national office. And before you knew it, there was a check in my mailbox from the Christmas Fund of the United Church of Christ. Wasn't a big check, but it was just enough to get me through until that next call came about. We are taking an offering tonight, not for this church, but for the Christmas Fund of the United Church of Christ. It is a fund that helps pastors who are in between, who are struggling, pastors who have retired without sufficient retirement funds. Whatever the need is, this is where your contributions are going tonight. And so we take this offering for them.
I see wind made moan, earth stood apart as I heard, water like stone, snow on snow. Thank you.
Into the light, we tremble and shine.
late comes, a blessing for Christmas Day by Jan Richardson. I can't tell you how the light comes. What I know is that it is more ancient than imagining. That it travels across an astounding expanse to reach us. That it love searches out, searching out what is hidden, what is lost, what is forgotten, or in peril or pain. That it has a fondness for the body, for finding its way towards flesh, for tracing the edges of form, for shining forth through the eye, the hand, and the art. I cannot tell you how the light comes, but that it does, that it will, that it works its way into the deepest dark that enfolds you, though it may seem long ages in coming or arriving in a shape you do not foresee. And so may we this day turn ourselves toward it. May we lift our faces to let it find us. May we bend our bodies to follow the arc it makes. May we open and open more, and open still to the blessed light that comes.
Thank you.
What I'd really like to give you for Christmas is a star. Brilliance in a package. Something you could keep in the pocket of your jeans or in the pocket of your being. Something to take out in times of darkness. Something that would never snuff out or tarnish. Something you could hold in your hand. Something for wonderment. Something for pondering. Something that would remind you of what Christmas has always meant. God's advent light into the darkness of this world. But stars are only God's for giving, and I must be content to give you words and wishes and packages without stars. But I can wish you life as radiant as the star that announced the Christ child's coming, and as filled with awe as the shepherds who stood beneath its light. And I can pass on to you the love that has been given to me, ignited countless times by others who have knelt in Bethlehem's light. Perhaps, if you ask, God will give you a star. Blessings to you on this night, blessings to your families and friends, and peace be with you as you leave. Merry Christmas to you.